In this video, we're going to talk about the mole. No, no, not the animal, but rather, a number. Avogadro's number is this number right here, 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd, or at least to 4 sig figs it is. Where this number comes from is it's defined as being the number of atoms of carbon-12 in exactly 12 grams of carbon-12. Remember, we have different isotopes. It ends up that the element carbon has several different isotopes, one of those being carbon-12, in which there are 6 protons and 6 neutrons in the nucleus. Well, if we had exactly 12 grams of carbon and we could count how many atoms there were in that 12 grams, that's Avogadro's number. That's how it's defined. And it ends up that at least to 4 sig figs, that number is 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd. Definitely memorize the number. And memorize it to 4 sig figs like I have it here for you. It's also a conversion factor because the mole that we're talking about here is defined, one mole of anything is defined as being Avogadro's number of that thing. So just basically fill in the blank. One mole of blank is equal to 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd of blank. For example, one mole of sand grains is equal to 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd grains of sand. Now, in reality, as chemists, most of the time we fill in the blank with something like atoms or molecules, but it could be anything. It's think about it like a dozen. If I said I was going to the store and I was going to buy 2 dozen eggs, well, everybody knows that I'd be getting 24 eggs. So you could say 1 dozen of blank is equal to 12 of blank. Same thing, right? And it is a conversion factor. This conversion factor right here lets us convert between moles of things and numbers of things. For example, let's say we have 1.75 moles of pennies and we want to find how many pennies we have. It's really best to treat this as a dimensional analysis problem because later on we're going to build on this concept and make make problems, solve problems where it's has several steps to it, and this will be one of the steps. So we want to know how many pennies there are in 1.75 moles. So our answer, the units for answer will be numbers of pennies, and our starting point is 1.75 moles of pennies. Our conversion factor, well, it'll be the definition of a mole. One mole of pennies is equal to 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd pennies, where I've just filled in the blank here now with pennies. Notice, okay, mole, M-O-L-E, well, we have an abbreviation, which isn't very much an abbreviation, but if we drop the E, M-O-L is the abbreviation for mole. So, finishing the problem, 1.75 moles of pennies, using our conversion factor, realizing that we have to cancel moles of pennies, so we put one mole of pennies on the bottom, putting Avogadro's number of pennies on the top, and you can see that the units cancel out. And we get our answer, 1.053 times 10 to the 24th pennies. We're only allowed 3 sig figs because of the 1.75. This has 4, this has 3, so we keep 3 sig figs. Now, the molar mass. Really important concept. The molar mass of anything, it's the mass of one mole of that thing. How much one mole of that thing weighs, typically in grams. And this right here in white is a really important concept. The molar mass of any element is the same number as its average atomic mass. Remember, we did average atomic mass a while back. So, for example, if we look at the periodic table, we can get the average atomic mass of any element. If we look up at carbon, we see that it's 12.011 AMUs for its average atomic mass. So now we also know the molar mass of carbon. It's 12.011 grams per mole. The units of molar mass are grams per mole. We could also say, as a conversion factor, that one mole of carbon is equal to 12.011 grams of carbon. And we'll do that right now. So here's a problem. We have 4.592 grams of lithium, and we want to find out, calculate, how many moles of lithium we have. Well, going between grams and moles now, the conversion factor is the molar mass. One mole of lithium is equal to 6.941 grams of lithium. Where did I get this number? I got it from the periodic table. I looked up the average atomic mass of lithium. I saw that it was 6.941 AMUs. And so that told me right there that the molar mass of lithium is 6.941 grams per mole, or as a conversion factor, 1 mole of lithium is equal to 6.941 grams of lithium. So, doing my dimensional analysis, the units that I want will be moles of lithium. So I leave a blank here in front of moles of lithium. And my starting point is how many grams I have. So 4.592 grams of lithium. I look at my conversion factor here. I have grams of lithium on top here as my starting point, so I need grams of lithium in the bottom. That puts moles of lithium on top. And again, units cancel. We get moles of lithium. And so we get 0.66157 moles of lithium. 4 sig figs in this number, 4 in this, so we keep 4 sig figs around there. So, okay, before we go on, we've now seen two different conversion factors, and they're really, really important conversion factors. First is Avogadro's number. Let's go back there. Avogadro's number converts between moles of things and numbers of things. Write that down, because people get this confused all the time. And then, so that's Avogadro's number. A mole of anything is equal to Avogadro's number of that thing, the individual things. Now, molar mass converts between grams and moles, right? Not numbers of things and moles, but grams. You see the difference there? And so if we know the molar mass of something, we can convert between moles of that and grams of that, just like we did here. Now, if we have a compound, the molar mass of the compound, it's just the sum of the molar masses of the atoms that make up that compound. For example, calcium nitrate. In one molecule of calcium nitrate, we have one formula unit, we have one atom of calcium, two atoms of nitrogen, and 2 times 3 is 6 atoms of oxygen. Well, the molar mass of calcium nitrate will just be the one times the molar mass of calcium, because there's one calcium, and 2 times the molar mass of nitrogen, and 6 times the molar mass of oxygen. So looking up at the periodic table, finding the molar masses, remember it's the same number as average atomic mass, we find calcium's 40.078 grams per mole, and there's one of those guys. Two nitrogens, each is 14.007 grams per mole, and 6 oxygens, each 15.999 grams per mole. Multiplying these out, I'm gonna warn you guys here, be careful of sig figs, show the individual steps. When I multiply, oh, by the way, these numbers, right, they're exact because we're counting things. The 1 and the 2 and the 6 are exact numbers. But the others aren't, right? This guy has 5 sig figs, this has 5, and this has 5. So when we multiply each out, we keep 5 sig figs. 40.078, 28.014, 95.994. But next, when we add, we look at where the last sig fig is. It ends up way it worked out here is the last sig fig was 3 places to the right of the decimal in each of these. So we keep 3 places to the right of the decimal in our answer, 164.086 grams per mole. Notice we have 6 sig figs now, even though all these guys had 5. So now we know the molar mass of calcium nitrate, 164.086 grams per mole, which means we have another conversion factor. We can convert between grams and moles for calcium nitrate. We now know that 1 mole of calcium nitrate is equal to 164.086 grams of calcium nitrate. So let's use that in a problem. Let's say we have 5.794 grams of calcium nitrate, and we want to find out how many moles of calcium nitrate there are. Well, there's our conversion factor, which is our molar mass. We just calculated this, right? So typically, if you have a problem like this, you won't already know the molar mass, so you have to do that calculation first to get your conversion factor. So we know 1 mole of calcium nitrate is equal to 164.086 grams of calcium nitrate. So setting up our dimensional analysis, the units of our answer will be moles of calcium nitrate. So we leave a blank in front of moles of calcium nitrate. And our starting point is 5.794 grams of calcium nitrate right here. Well, we need grams of calcium nitrate on the bottom. So we come up here, take that, put it down there. The other side of the equal sign goes on top. And our units cancel. Grams of calcium nitrate here, cancel here, and we end up with moles of calcium nitrate here. And because we have 4 sig figs in the 5.794 and 6 in the 164.086, the 1 is exact, we keep 4 sig figs in our answer. So the answer is 0.03531 moles of calcium nitrate.